Hi, and welcome to MoneySmartFamily.com and America's Cheapest Family, where we try to get the best value for every dollar we spend. I'm Steve Economidis, and as a former gymnast in my college days, I competed nationally and internationally. I was an All-American in the U.S., and my goal as I get older and closer to retirement is to try and stay in shape and keep aging from slowing me down. I've been diving into a pretty fascinating research study on something called molecular hydrogen. Now, this isn't going to be a science lesson. This is basically a summary of a research paper that I put on our website, MoneySmartFamily.com, about the health benefits of breathing and drinking molecular hydrogen, Brown's gas, or HHO. And we're going to tell you more about that in this video. Before we get started with the research, I just had to ask this question, how important is hydrogen to us? I mean, I know it's the first element in the periodic table. And, water, we drink water. Well, water is H2O, so it's hydrogen and oxygen. But bottom line is our bodies are made up of a lot of water, and most of water is made up of hydrogen. So hydrogen is pretty important. And how do we get hydrogen in our bodies? Well, it's through eating foods, it's through the digestive process, it's through drinking water. But this study that I've been doing is on ways to get more hydrogen into your body and the effects it has on improving your health and improving your performance if you're an athlete. We got started on this journey about a year ago. We met some friends through a Facebook gardening group, George and Marlene, and in their front room, they had this funky looking machine, looked kind of like a tower computer, but it was white and had flashing lights on it and had tubes coming out of it. And I asked George what it was, and he said, well, this is a Brown's gas machine. You start with distilled water and an electrolyte. In this case, they use a little bit of lye in the water to create electrolysis. The water is charged with diodes, and it produces a gas. The gas is scrubbed through some bubblers, and you breathe it, and it produces results in your body. So George was telling me a little bit about this, and it was really over my head, but what he did is he pulled up his pant leg and he showed me a diabetic ulcer on his leg just below his kneecap. And it was about 4 inches wide and about 3/4 of an inch tall. And he told me that the doctors had been telling him that he should consider having his leg amputated. And that's pretty serious. And this is he's a guy, he's about 6'4", and he's a big guy. He fought in Vietnam. So he's in his 70s, but he wasn't about to have his leg amputated. So he did some research, and he bought this Brown's gas machine, and he had been for about a month gassing his leg, and he said he'd seen amazing improvement on the diabetic ulcer, and it had gotten smaller. Well, fast forward 9 months, and now I just talked to his wife, and she said the ulcer is down to about an inch wide, and doctors aren't talking anymore about amputation. They're telling him that he needs to spend less time being active and more time off his feet so it'll heal faster. So this was our first introduction to it. Then probably about 2 months ago, we were heading to their house for a potluck and had a young friend staying with us, Joshua, and he had some psoriatic arthritis on his hand, right in the web of his thumb, and he'd been treating it with various creams and lotions and cortisone and stuff like that for about 2 months, and it was getting worse. And so I suggested that he come with us to the potluck at George and Marlene's house, and that we ask George if we could gas his hand with the Brown's gas. George agreed, and about 2 weeks later, this is what Josh's hand looked like. Now, this wasn't a scientific experiment, because what we did is we gassed it for half an hour, and then George put some frankincense oil on it. So we aren't sure if it was the frankincense or the Brown's gas or a combination of the two. But either way, that instance made me even more convinced that I really wanted to do a deep dive in this and possibly get my own Brown's gas generator to try it on myself. So in the course of my research, what really convinced me was not only these two instances that I witnessed myself, but I started doing some reading on several different Brown's gas generator websites, and there is a consistent story of people using the Brown's gas or drinking the hydrogenized water and seeing incredible health improvements. And there's a consistency with them. Like there's this one, a person named D. Mason wrote in and said that they were able to get their blood pressure significantly lower using Brown's gas and not taking medication. Another person saw huge improvement on varicose veins. There are two videos on this website, and we will have links to all of this and the article that we've written in the show notes. Two different videos that really affected me. I've got two friends with Parkinson's, and one of them is my big brother from college, and he is just a little older than me, and he is suffering pretty bad shakes and tremors. And these two videos show in a period of about half an hour, two different people with Parkinson's, their tremors just subsiding and their body resting. And then there were scientific studies, and there are hundreds and hundreds of them dating back as far as about 2008. For instance, this one is the therapeutic potential of molecular hydrogen in metabolic diseases. And this one was done in March of 2023, and it saw value in treating some diseases with Brown's gas. And then here's a huge study. This is from January of 2023. There were 1,000 people with diabetes who agreed to breathe Brown's gas for 25 hours a week for 6 months, and they saw overall 94% of the group had improved blood sugar control, lower cholesterol, insulin function was improved, glycemic tests were lower, glycemic targets were lower. A huge improvement for diabetes. This is another study from 2011. It's recent progress towards hydrogen medicine, the potential of molecular hydrogen for preventative and therapeutic actions. This study just goes into a lot of details about how hydrogen, when it's breathed or taken internally, destroys free radicals and helps your body balance and improves digestion and improves circulation. A lot of really good things. And I've marked this article up and I summarize it in the article that I wrote, but I also have links to it. This one is on brain ischemia, which happens after heart attacks. And this was a whole double-blind, placebo-based controlled study of people who had heart attacks and then were given molecular hydrogen to prevent them having further brain problems. The studies are amazing, and while I don't understand every word in them, I get the gist of it, and there's just overwhelming evidence that there are tons of positive side effects and very few negative side effects, if any. I looked up stuff like, what are the side effects or the negative side effects of breathing hydrogen gas? And I didn't find any. And then what's got even more interesting is I was watching a podcast, an athletic performance podcast, and this guy was saying that he was taking hydrogen pills to improve his performance, but they were much more expensive than buying a hydrogen generator and breathing the hydrogenized gas and drinking the hydrogenized water. So that got me onto another rabbit trail of looking at studies on athletic performance. And there are some cool testimonials. One website had listed a bunch of professional athletes who were really sold on the performance enhancing aspects of drinking hydrogenized water and taking hydrogen pills. And I don't know these people, but they mentioned people like Roger Snipes, Walter Harris. They are either weightlifters or MMA fighters. And they're using this for performance enhancement. And they also cited that there were a number of NFL, NHL, and NBA players who were doing the same thing. This isn't like steroids, but it is a way to improve your circulation, improve your breathing, and improve your body's functions. This is the AquaCure AC50. It's a Brown's gas HHO hydroxy generator. And basically what happens is inside this chassis, there's a container where the water and lye are mixed together and there are electrodes. It turns the water into a gas. The gas comes up here. It goes down through this tube into this bubbler over here. This bubbler is a scrubber. It comes out of the bubbler and goes into this jar here. for the second bubbling, and then the air comes out and you either breathe it or gas a part of your body with it. And that is the simplest explanation I can give you for how this works. I've been using this machine for about 60 hours in the past 4 weeks. And I'm not going to go into the changes I'm seeing now, but I just wanted you to see this machine. Now I'm going to talk about how this was developed and some of the things that they've seen that have happened to people who use this. Now, this Brown's gas generator is from AquaCure, and I've worked out an affiliate agreement with them. If you go to the website to buy an AquaCure and you use the coupon code MoneySmartHealth, you can get 5% off. And it's not a lot, but it's something that will help make this more affordable. My goal is to improve my health and hopefully get this into the hands of some friends of mine who could really use it, especially the ones suffering through Parkinson's. I have another friend who's got the start of Alzheimer's, and there have been people who've claimed that this can help prevent Alzheimer's or reverse it to some degree. So again, I'm trying to be really careful in what I say, because these haven't been scientific studies, but if what people are saying is happening to them is true, then this really could be a very good thing for a lot of people. So let's talk about what Brown's gas is, how it was developed, and it's a very interesting story. There was a professor in Austria named Professor Yul Brown, and in 1973, he was working in his lab to build a welding machine that would work off of hydrogen gas, and it was used in the welding industry for quite some time. Around 1996, there was an inventor named George Wiseman. He's up in Canada, and he wanted to be able to weld titanium to plastic. And he was looking to get a Brown's gas welder, and it was going to cost him $30,000. And he said, I don't want to spend $30,000. So he built his own Brown's gas generator, and later ended up selling it as a device called the water torch, because it uses water with an electrolyte in it to produce the gas at the right volume and right intensity to start a flame. One of his clients who bought the water torch called him up one day and said, you know, I've been doing something with the water, and I don't know if you've heard of this, but this particular client had a melanoma on his head and was taking the hydrogen water, which is the byproduct of the gas over here, and he was dabbing a cotton ball in it and putting the water on his melanoma several times a day. And over the course of a month or so, the melanoma went away. And then people started saying that they were drinking the water and breathing the gas. And George wasn't sure that was a good idea, but they were starting to see good effects, like having more energy and having scars disappear. And so he started testing it, and in 2005, he actually has a video on his site where he breathes the Brown's gas for the first time, and he wasn't sure what was going to happen to him, so he documented it with a video. Since that point in time, they've sold thousands of these units, and people have been breathing the hydrogen gas with some phenomenal results. Here's what I'm testing it on, and I'm kind of excited to do this, but it's taking a little time. I'm testing it on the squamous cell cancer. I also have, I do a lot of yard work, and as a matter of fact, yesterday I was doing some shoveling and raking, and this morning my hands were a little bit sore. They feel a little swollen. I also play guitar. I play classical guitar, and so every morning when I wake up, I check my joints to see how swollen they are. And what I've done for this test for the past month is I've stopped taking things like turmeric and glucosamine. And what I'm noticing is my hands aren't nearly as swollen in the morning. That's just anecdotal, but that's what I'm testing it on. I'm also, as I'm getting older, my skin is turning kind of crepey, whatever you want to call it. It looks kind of scaly, and I'm noticing that it's a little bit smoother and little less crepey. One other thing I'm noticing besides the squamous cell cancer, the joint inflammation, and the skin change is that I'm not nearly as tired at night. I usually get up around 6 o'clock. I go to bed between 10 and 11. And at the end of the night, I'm not as fatigued, let's call it. And I don't feel like I'm caffeinated, but I definitely feel less tired. I'll be able to sleep just fine, but I don't feel dog tired. So I'm impressed with those changes in just a month's time. So this is just the beginning of the journey. And like I said, I will do a video updating what I have been doing, how many hours a day I've been using it, and what the results are on a day-by-day basis. But I just wanted to share kind of the overview of Brown's gas, where it came from, what its claims are, some of the research studies that have been done. But I want to ask you a question. So what do you think? Is this a scam? Is this legit? Take some time, look at some of the research studies, read our article on MoneySmartFamily.com, and leave comments below or on our website. Feel free to reach out to us through the contact form on our website. Remember, if you do want to buy one of these, you can use the code MoneySmartHealth to get a discount on your unit. Remember, this is all about spending money wisely. It's about getting the best quality for the best price. And it's about living life to the fullest and enjoying your life, enjoying your friends, and enjoying your family. So until next time, this is Steve from Money Smart Family. Please leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts. Subscribe to our channel or watch these videos next. And watch these videos next. Cheers. This is hydrogenized water, and I'm just finishing my second 24-ounce cup of it for the day. It's so tasty, too.